You're watching TV9 News.
The concept of teaching comes from the very start of communication, from Socrates to Bill Nye to Logan Paul. Since the beginning of time, humans were forced to ascertain either knowledge from their own empiricisms, their ancestors, compatriots, by what civilization likes to call teachers. Even the most vacuous of individuals can learn something new every day.
Teachers work too hard on grading homework and getting class organized.
Well, actually.
Frick, I gotta get these things graded. Oh my god. Well, I really don't feel like grading these. I don't think the kids will ever remember that. There go those. I'll get these graded here real quick. Yeah, this is garbage. That's an easy F right there. I can't read that kid's name. Forget that. I don't feel like doing these either. I think the garbage is the best place for these things. Let's go back to napping.
Teachers will never walk out on you.
Well, actually...
I did see that. Okay, thank you. And... Oh, hold on. I'll have to come back in a little bit. I need to do my steps. It says on my Fitbit that I didn't do enough steps this hour, so I'll be right back. Here we go.
Science teachers don't understand that the Earth is definitely not spherical.
Well, actually...
So ladies and gentlemen, a review of the concepts today is that the Earth as you once knew it is not correct. It is not indeed a sphere. Based on all the evidence that's been gathered for the past 20 or 30 years, we have come to the conclusion that with all the sugar that humans on Earth have been ingesting, putting into their systems, the Earth must indeed be a donut.
Teachers are always there to show their support and help out whenever they can.
Well, actually...
Ralph, I'm confused by this.
Abby, how can you be so confused? It is nothing but basic trig. What? I know you think that sine means sin. It's sine. Come on. Do you not even know what secant of 3 pi over 4 is? What is the secant of 3 pi over 4? Come on. Would you draw me a circle, please? Draw me a circle. 2/3. Abby, where's 2/3 on that circle? 2/3. 2/3, Abby. 2/3.
I have a feeling a lot of the teachers don't give us the true story.
Well, actually...
A lot of times people ask me, why do you take history? My answer to that is, you learn a lot of historic facts. For example, the discovery of gold in California, that was me. The development of the atomic bomb, that was me. The invasion of Normandy, I led that. That's why you should be in history, to learn the great things I did. I'm all around. I'm the all-around history guy.
It seems like a job with very few breaks. They definitely don't get much downtime.
Well, actually...
The sign-offs, help me! I need you to help me with my essay.
See ya.
What?
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now, here are today's announcements from the TV9 studio.
Well, in Roswell, New Mexico, isn't it? After an unidentified flying saucer crashes onto T. Boone's ranch. Now he has his hands full dealing with government officials, the press, his family, and a cheesy science fiction film production team is on the ranch. This fast-paced comedy includes both real and fake aliens, mistaken identities, interesting family dynamics, physical comedy, and mining for the truth. If this sounds like fun, consider auditioning for the spring play All's Well in Roswell, Isn't It? On Tuesday, March 3rd after school, or Wednesday, March 4th after school. Sign up in room 233 and show up and have fun. Find out if all is well in Roswell.
A list of students who have earned these academic awards is posted in the administration's office. These students will be recognized at an award ceremony on March 13th at 10 a.m. in the Fieldhouse.
If your name is not on the list and you believe you've earned an award, please see Mrs. Pomeranian in the administration office this week.
Thank you for watching TV9 News. Have a great day.